Exodus 30 through 35. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray that everyone is blessed. I thank you so much for everything, In Jesus' name, amen. Then make a small altar out of acacia wood for burning incense. It must be 18 inches square, 3 feet high, with horns at the corner carved from the same piece of wood as the altar. Overlay the top, sides, and horns of the altar with pure gold and run a gold molding around the entire altar. Beneath the molding, on opposite sides of the altar, attach two gold rings to support the carrying poles. The poles are to be made of acacia wood and overlay with gold. Place the incense altar just outside the inner curtain, opposite the ark's cover, the place of atonement that rests on the Ark of the Covenant. I will meet with you there. Every morning when Aaron trims the lamps, he must burn fragrant incense on the altar. And each evening when he tends to the lamps, he must again burn incense in the Lord's presence. This must be done from generation to generation. Do not offer any unholy incense on your altar or any burnt offerings, grain offerings, or drink offerings. Once a year, Aaron must purify the altar by placing on its horns the blood from the offering made from the atonement of sin. This will be a regular annual event from generation to generation, for this is the Lord's supremely holy altar. And the Lord said to Moses, "Whenever you take a census of the people of Israel, each man who is counted must pay a ransom for himself to the Lord. Then there will be no plagues among the people as you count them. His payment to the Lord will be 1/5 of an ounce of silver. All who have reached their 20th birthday must give this offering to the Lord. When this offering is given to the Lord to make atonement for yourselves, the rich must not give more, and the poor must not give less. Use this money for the care of the tabernacle. It will bring you, the Israelites, to the Lord's attention, and it will make atonement for your lives." And the Lord said to Moses, "Make a large bronze basin with a bronze pedestal. Put it between the tabernacle and the altar, and fill it with water. Aaron and his sons will wash their hands and feet there. Before they go into the tabernacle to appear before the Lord, and before they approach the altar to burn offerings to the Lord, they must always wash before ministering in these ways, or they will die. This is a permanent law for Aaron and his descendants to be kept from generation to generation." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Collect choice spices, 12.5 pounds of pure myrrh, 6 1/4 pounds each of cinnamon and sweet cane, 12.5 pounds of cassia, and 1 gallon of olive oil. Blend these ingredients into a holy anointing oil. Use this scented oil to anoint the tabernacle, the Ark of the Covenant, and the table, and all its utensils, the lampstand, and all its accessories, the incense altar, the altar of burnt offerings with all its utensils, and the large wash basin with its pedestal. Sanctify them to make them entirely holy. After this, whatever touches them will become holy. Use this oil also to anoint Aaron and his sons, sanctifying them so they can minister before me as priests. And say to the people of Israel, this will always be a holy anointing oil. It must never be poured on the body of an ordinary person, and you must never make any of it yourselves. It is holy, and you must treat it as holy. Anyone who blends scented oil like it or puts any of it on someone who is not a priest will be cut off from the community." These were the Lord's instructions to Moses concerning the incense. Gather sweet spices, resin droplets, mollusk scent, galbanum, and pure frankincense, weighing out the same amounts of each. Using the usual techniques of the incense maker, refine it to produce a pure and holy incense. Beat some of it very fine and put some of it in the front of the ark of the covenant, where I will meet with you in the tabernacle. This incense is most holy. Never make the incense for yourself. It is reserved for the Lord, and you must treat it as holy. Those who make it for their own enjoyment will be cut off from the community. The Lord also said to Moses, "Look, I have chosen Bezalel, son of Uri, grandson of Hur, of the tribe of Judah. I have filled him with the Spirit of God, giving him great wisdom, intelligence, and skill in all kinds of crafts. He is able to create beautiful objects from gold, silver, and bronze. He is skilled in cutting and setting gemstones and engraving wood. Yes, he is a master of every craft. And I have anointed Aholiab, son of Ahishamach, of the tribe of Dan, to be his assistant. Moreover, I have given special skill to all the natural, talented craftsmen so they can make all the things I have instructed you to make. The tabernacle itself, the Ark of the Covenant, the Ark's cover, the place of atonement, all the furnishings of the tabernacle, the table and all its utensils, the gold lampstand with all its accessories, the incense altar, the altar of burnt offering with all its utensils, the wash basin and its pedestal, the beautifully stitched holy garments for Aaron the priest and the garments for his sons to wear as they minister as priests, the anointing oil and the special incense for the holy place. They must follow exactly all the instructions I have given you." The Lord then gave these further instructions to Moses. "Tell the people of Israel to keep my Sabbath day, for the Sabbath is a sign of the covenant between me and you forever. It helps you to remember that I am the Lord who makes you holy. Yes, keep the Sabbath day, for it is holy. Anyone who desecrates it must die. Anyone who works on that day will be cut off from the community. Work 6 days only, but the seventh day must be a day of total rest. I repeat, because the Lord considers it a holy day, anyone who works on the Sabbath must be put to death. The people of Israel must keep the Sabbath day forever. It is a permanent sign of my covenant with them. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, but he rested on the seventh day and was refreshed." Then, as the Lord finished speaking with Moses on Mount Sinai, he gave him the 2 stone tablets inscribed with the terms of the covenant, written by the finger of God. When Moses failed to come back down the mountain right away, the people went to Aaron. "Look," they said, "make us some gods who can lead us. This man Moses, who brought us here from Egypt, has disappeared. We don't know what has happened to him." So Aaron said, "Tell your wives and sons and daughters to take off their gold earrings and then bring them to me." All the people obeyed Aaron and brought him their gold earrings. Then Aaron took the gold, melted it down, and molded and tooled it into the shape of a calf. The people exclaimed, "O Israel, these are the gods who brought you out of Egypt." Then Aaron saw how excited the people were about it. He built an altar in front of it, the calf, and announced, "Tomorrow there will be a festival to the Lord." So the people got up early the next morning to sacrifice burnt offerings and peace offerings. After this, they celebrated with feasting and drinking and indulging themselves in pagan revelry. Then the Lord told Moses, "Quick, go down the mountain. The people you brought from Egypt have defiled themselves. They have already turned from the way I commanded them to live. They have made an idol shaped like a calf, and they have worshipped the sacrifice to it. They are saying, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you out of Egypt.'" Then the Lord said, "I have seen how stubborn and rebellious these people are. Now leave me alone so my anger can blaze against them and destroy them all. Then I will make you, Moses, into a great nation instead of them." But Moses pleaded with the Lord, his God, not to do it. "O Lord," he exclaimed, "why are you so angry with your people, whom you brought from the land of Egypt with such great power and mighty acts? The Egyptians will say, 'God tricked them into coming to the mountain so he could kill them and wipe them from the face of the earth.' Turn away from your fierce anger. Change your mind about this terrible disaster you are planning against your people. Remember your covenant with your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You swore by your own self, I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars of heaven. Yes, I will give them all of this land that I have promised to your descendants, and they will possess it forever. The Lord withdrew his threat and didn't bring against the people the disaster he had threatened. Then Moses turned and went down the mountain. He held in his hand the two stone tablets inscribed with the terms of the covenant. They were inscribed on both sides, front and back. These stone tablets were God's work. The words on them were written by God himself. When Joshua heard the noise of the people shouting below them, he exclaimed to Moses, "It sounds as if there is a war in the camp." But Moses replied, "No, it's neither a cry of victory nor a cry of defeat. It is the sound of celebration." When they came near the camp, Moses saw the calf and the dancing. In terrible anger, he threw the stone tablets to the ground, smashing them at the foot of the mountain. And he took the calf they had made and melted it in the fire. And when the metal had cooled, he ground it into powder and mixed it with water. Then he made the people drink it. After that, he turned to Aaron. "What did the people do to you?" he demanded. "How did they ever make you bring such terrible sin upon them?" "Don't get upset, sir," Aaron replied. "You yourself know these people and what a wicked bunch they are. They said to me, 'Make us some gods to lead us, for something has happened to this man Moses who led us out of Egypt.' So I told them, 'Bring me your gold earrings.' When they brought them to me, I threw them into the fire and out came this calf." When Moses saw that Aaron had let the people get completely out of control, and much to the amusement of their enemies, he stood at the entrance to the camp and shouted, "All of you who are on the Lord's side, come over here and join me." And all the Levites came. He told them, "This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says, strap on your swords, go back and forth from one end of the camp to the other, killing even your brothers, friends, and neighbors." The Levites obeyed Moses, and about 3,000 people died that day. Then Moses told the Levites, "Today you have been ordained for the service of the Lord, for you obeyed him even though it meant killing your own sons and brothers. Because of this, he will now give you a great blessing." The next day Moses said to the people, "You have committed a terrible sin, but I will return to the Lord on the mountain. Perhaps I will be able to obtain forgiveness for you." So Moses returned to the Lord and said, "Alas, these people have committed a terrible sin. They have made gods of gold for themselves. But now, please forgive them of their sins. And if not, then blot me out of the record you are keeping." The Lord replied to Moses, "I will blot out whoever has sinned against me. Now go, lead the people to the place I told you about. Look, my angel will lead the way before you. But when I call the people to account, I will certainly punish them for their sins." And the Lord sent a great plague upon the people because they had worshipped the calf Aaron had made.